गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू DSS ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी विल रीडिंग प्रैक्टिस द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 5, दैट इज़ व्हेन पीपल रिबेल 1857 एंड आफ्टर, एंड फाइंड आउट सम डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग, एंड आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज़ अ म्यूटनी बिकम्स अ पावर पॉपुलर रिबेलियन। दो स्ट्रगल्स बिटवीन रूलर्स एंड द रूल्ड आर नॉट अनयूजुअल। समटाइम्स such struggles become quite widespread as a popular resistance, so that the power of the state breaks down. A very large number of people begin to believe that they have a common enemy and rise up against the enemy at the same time. For such a situation to develop, people have to organize, communicate, take initiative and display the confidence to turn the situation around. Such a situation developed in the northern parts of India in 1857 after 100 years of conquest and administration. The English East India Company faced a massive rebellion that started in May 1857 and threatened the company's very presence in India. Sepoys mutinied in several places, beginning from Meerut, and a large number of people from different sections of society rose up in rebellion. Some regard it as the biggest armed resistance to colonialism in the 19th century anywhere in the world. Our next topic is from Meerut to Delhi. On 29th March 1857, a young soldier, Mangal Pandey, was hanged to death for attacking his officers in Barakpur. Some days later, some sepoys of the regiment at Meerut refused to do the army drill using the new cartridges, which were suspected of being coated with the fat of cows and pigs. 85 sepoys were dismissed from service and sentenced to 10 years in jail for disobeying their officers. That happened on 9 May 1857. The response of the other Indian soldiers in Meerut was quite extraordinary. On 10th May, the soldiers marched to the jail in Meerut and released the imprisoned sepoys. They attacked and killed British officials. They captured gun and ammunition and set fire to the buildings and properties of the British and declared war on the Firangis. The soldiers were determined to bring an end to their rule in the country. But who would rule the land instead? The soldiers had an answer to this question: the Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar. The sepoys of Meerut rode all night of 10th May to reach Delhi in the early hour next morning. As news of their arrival spread, the regiments stationed in Delhi also rose up in rebellion. Again, British officials were killed, armed and ammunition seized, buildings set on fire. Triumphant soldiers gathered around the wall of the Red Fort where the Badshah lived, demanding to meet him. The emperor was not quite willing to challenge the mighty British power, but the soldiers persisted. They forced their way into the palace and proclaimed Bahadur Shah Zafar as their leader. The aging emperor had to accept this demand. He wrote letters to all the chiefs and rulers of the country to come forward and organize a confederacy of Indian states to fight the British. The single step taken by Bahadur Shah had a great implications. The Mughal dynasty had ruled over a very large part of the country. Most smaller rulers and chieftains controlled different territories on behalf of the Mughal ruler. Threatened by the expansion of British rule, many of them felt that if the Mughal emperor could rule again, they too would be able to rule their own territories once more under Mughal authority. The British had not accepted this to happen. They thought the disturbance caused by the issue of the cartridges would die down. But Bahadur Shah Zafar's decision to bless the rebellion changed the entire situation dramatically. Often, when people see an alternative possibilities, they feel inspired and enthused. It gives them the courage, hope, and confidence to act. The rebellion spreads. After the British were routed from Delhi, there was no uprising for almost a week. It took the much time for news to travel. Then a sprout of mutiny began. Regiment after regiment mutinied and took off to join other troops at nodal points like Delhi, Kanpur and Lucknow. After them, the people of the town and villages also rose up in rebellion and rallied around local leaders, zamindars and chiefs who were prepared to establish their authority and fight the British. Nana Saheb, the adopted son of the late Peshwa Baji Rao, who lived near Kanpur, gathered armed force and expelled the British garrison from the city. He proclaimed himself Peshwa. He declared that he was a governor under Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar. In Lucknow, Brijesh Kadar, the son of the deposed Nawab Wajid Ali Shah, was proclaimed the new Nawab. He too acknowledged the suzerainty of Bahadur Shah Zafar. His mother Begum Hazrat Mahal took an active part in organizing the uprising against the British in Jhansi. Rani Lakshmibai joined the rebel sepoys and fought the British along with Tatya Tope, the general of Nana Saheb. In the Mandal region of Madhya Pradesh, Rani Avanti Bai Lodhi of Ramgarh raised and led an army of 4,000 against the British who had taken over the administration of her state. The British were generally outnumbered by the rebel forces. They were defeated in the number of battles. This convinced the people that the rule of British had collapsed for good and gave them the confidence to take the plunge and join the rebellion. A situation of widespread popular rebellion developed in the region of Awadh in particular. On 6 August 1857, we find a telegram sent by Lieutenant Colonel Tyler to his commander-in-chief expressing the fear felt by the British. Our men are cowed by the number opposed to them and the endless fighting. Every village is held against us. The zamindar have risen to oppose us. Many new leaders came up, for example, Ahmadullah Shah, a Maulvi from Faizabad, prophesied that the rule of the British would come to an end soon. He caught the imagination of the people and raised a huge force of the supporters. He came to Lucknow to fight the British in Delhi. A large number of Ghazis or religious warrior come together to wipe out the white people. Bakht Khan, a soldier from Bareilly, took charge of a large force of fighters who came to Delhi. He became a key military leader of the rebellion. In Bihar, an old zamindar, Kunwar Singh, joined the rebel sepoys and battled with the British for many months. Leaders and fighters from across the land joined the fight. So students, now remaining part of the chapter is हम लोग उसको कवर करेंगे नेक्स्ट वीडियो में. थैंक यू.